do you have an item that you don't use anymore and you want to sell it outside to someone? Or do you work in a company and you have a lot of products that you want to ship internationally, but you don't know how to sell it across internationally? Well, in this video, I'll show you guys how to successfully sell on eBay and also the best practices that people have been missing. I'll go through these 5 steps that I laid out to show you guys the best practices to practice in order to make the highest conversion for you, to get a whole lot of profit for you. That's what I'll be covering in this video. So without further ado, guys, let's dive right into it. Welcome back, guys. I'm Chido Olujina. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this channel, I teach you guys anything and everything you need to know about making money online, investing your money and making your money work for you. So you might consider hitting that red subscribe button below and turning on the bell notification beside it, so you'll be notified each time I drop great videos like this. So today's topic, I'm telling you guys the best practices to use to sell on eBay. So before I get into that, I want to educate you guys a little bit about eBay. In case you don't know what eBay is, eBay is an American multinational e-commerce corporation based in St. Joe's, California, that facilitates consumers to consumers and business to consumer sales through its website. So basically what they do, let me break it down for those of you that don't understand, is maybe you have an item that you want to sell, like you have this speaker, this is a Bluetooth speaker that you want to sell. You can easily snap this and do all the proper SEOs and put it out there on eBay. And somebody maybe in China or wherever wants to buy it, they can easily request to buy this particular Bluetooth speaker and they will ship it across to them. So this eBay helps you to do that. So they will ship it across to them and give you your profit, and they collect their own percentage. So everyone is happy. So that's just basically what they do. So basically, I'll go through these 5 criteria on how to do a proper SEO on eBay to get the most profitable benefit out of it. So the first one is research, the second one is title and description, the third one is photography, the fourth one is selling format, the fifth one is shipping. So I'll tell you guys all the best practices, and if you stick to the very end, I'll give you guys a bonus tip that many people are not using. This is a pro tip to give you guys in order to succeed. So that being said, this is the website on eBay. So before you start selling something, you actually have to have an account with them. So you have to register an order. So the first step is to quickly register. Come here and click on register, and you can easily register on their website. So once you register, you can help you to start selling stuff online. So first of all, they'll ask you for your name. So let me just use this for the purpose of this tutorial. So this is Jima. So this is the name I want to use, but use it as your own implies, and I encourage you guys to use your legit email, don't use any fake email here. So this is what I want to use, 247@gmail.com. So this is my official email in case you want to contact me for business purposes. So here I'll quickly put a password that I can remember. So let me do this. So this is the password I want to use, and I'll click on create account. So they'll send me a verification email which I'll just confirm, and my account is created. And after that, I'll show you guys how to start promoting or selling items on eBay. So they have sent me the verification email which I'll just verify. It's just simple. So after registering, you can see here, hi Chido. So come here that it says sell. So I can simply save this. Come here they say sell, click on sell, and it will load up an interface whereby you can input what you want to sell. So the first criteria that I listed here is research. So before you sell anything, for example, you want to sell a Samsung TV. Before you sell anything, you have to make a research and know how much the particular Samsung TV that you are selling goes for. How much is it in the market? Is it $100? Is it $200? Is it $500? Whatever it is, make the proper research. So once you click on sell on eBay, they will ask you, tell us what you are selling. So for example, I might say, what I want to sell is a Samsung TV. So I might just write Samsung TV here and say get started. So it will now give me results of similar Samsung TVs out there, and I can model what they have done here. Or if I can't find anyone that shows what I want to sell, I can easily start from scratch. For example, if I want to sell a TV like this, Samsung 4 series, this is the code for the Samsung TV, and it's 32 inches and it's 720 pixels HD LED. So internet TV, so it's an internet TV. So I'll check if I can see any TV that is similar to what I want to sell. So whatever it is, I can easily select this. For instance, this one, I've selected this, so I can easily go through all this, and if it's in line with what I want to use, I can simply model this template, so they will save time for me. So that's why I'm doing it this way, so they will save time and I can easily start putting all the information I need. So this is, they have copied the title and everything here down here, but I'll quickly show you guys the proper way to get your title. And so here is the title. For example, this is the default title that it modeled from the item I selected, but if there's any changes, maybe the serial number, I can easily change it. Maybe this is AU, and I put the figure here, whatever it is, the inches, maybe I'm selling a 57 inches or 21 inches or whatever inches I'm selling, I'll put it here. If it's a smart TV, I'll put it here as well. So whatever the TV is, make sure you put the accurate description. Don't come here and put a fake description, put the accurate description. So to stand out, you can use bold title. So if I use bold title, it will stand out. But there's another extra fee of $2. So just keep that in mind as well. Now here, you can add another subtitle, which is an additional fee of $1. So I can add another subtitle just to make my own stand out, because there's a lot of competition on eBay, and you guys have to go on that auction and bidding, and I'll go to that in two details in this video. So make sure it's still in there. And so you can add a subtitle like Samsung 2021 TV, 2021 latest TV, and I just say something like this, or any other thing you want to add, you can add just a subtitle that you want to add. Then variations, you can add the format, the condition. Please, if you have used it before, you can say that it's used here. Yeah, if it's new, put it new. If it's open box, put it as your own implies. I will encourage you guys to do the honest, put the honest information here. Don't put any fake information. So that's for the title. For the description, which I'll get in a bit. So the description is down here. So here is where you put your item description. So describe your item honestly. Don't try to put any fake or try to overhype your item while your item is not what it is. So just put your honest description here so that you get the best out of it, so that the buyer will know what they are buying, and also will rate you well, so that in future you also, they will also buy from you, right? So like I keep saying, when it comes to online marketing and all that, rating and reviews is just the key. So if you do something that is dishonest and someone, they won't patronize you and they'll give you a poor rating, and in the future nobody will buy from you. So the third tip is photography. So I encourage you guys to post sharp pictures that is crisp clear, and also use a white background to snap it. Like for instance, this TV is snapped on a white background or a neutral color. So, but most recommended is white background, so that they can see all the edges. And if you're a good editor, you can easily edit this using Photoshop or any editing software out there to make it more colorful and more bright. This is a strategy and a bonus tip in order to convert a whole lot of sales. And another thing is to add multiple pictures there. As you can see there, you can add up to 12 pictures here, and I encourage you guys, if possible, to add all the 12 pictures here and snap in all angles. Don't just snap from the front, snap from the back, from the side, from the inclined angle, any angle that you can get, snap it and make all of them crystal clear in the white background. So once you do that, your conversion rate is already increased up to 50%. So that's the way to go about your photography. So the next one is your selling format. So when it comes to the selling format, which I'll show you guys in a bit, but before then, you have the model here. You can fill in the model depending on the item you want to sell. So put the particular model that you want to sell here, select it. Then here is where you can put the 3D technology. If it's applicable, you can add it as well. So here's your description. Like I said, put an honest description about the product you want to sell. Don't come here and fabricate a lie just to hype your product. It will still backfire to you. So coming down to the selling details, which I told you guys, that selling format, So here is where you select whether it's auction style or fixed price. Different auction style is that they will bid your item between buyers to know the best price. Anyone that has the best or highest price will automatically buy the item. But if you put a fixed price, it has to go for that price, for that fixed price. So that's different. But my own recommendation, like I told you guys, say do not stick, leave it at auction style, so that even if maybe you won't sell it for, let me say, 500 USD, you might actually sell it for 1000 USD, but someone auctioned it higher, they need it more than the other person. So that's a bonus tip. Duration, you can leave it at 7 days, maximum is 10 days, but 7 days is actually okay. So the listing starts on, I would encourage you guys to set this on Sunday by 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. That's my recommendation. You might want to write this down, write it down in the notepad somewhere. On Sunday by 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. That's the best time to set your item on auction, so that you get the best out of it, because that's when auction starts actually. So here is where you put your starting price for the auction, and you can add your buy it now price. For example, I might say starting price might be 100 USD, then if anybody that is willing to pay 500 USD, you automatically buy it now, hands down. I don't encourage you guys to put a reserve price, because reserve price means if someone reserves it, there's no auction again, they have already reserved the whole thing, so it might conflict with everything. So just leave this to like this, or you can even remove this if you don't want to. So anyone, this applies to you. So you can click best offers, buys it. So if anybody that has the best offer will buy this, then you put the quantity that you want to, then you put the payment options, PayPal, your received by PayPal, email and all that. So just add your information, your tax information here, your return option. If this return, maybe they don't like the item, they can easily return it to you. So you can easily tick on them, domestic return accepted, international return accepted. So that's how this one works. So I'll quickly come to the last tip I'm going to be showing you guys, which is shipping. Okay guys, so the final tip is for the shipping details. So when it comes to shipping details, so domestic shipping, you can add whether it's cost to all buyers, like the same cost for all buyers, it doesn't matter where they are, or you can see cost varies via location, or cost varies via the item size, or no shipping at all, they have to come to the warehouse and pick it directly. So this is for domestic shipping. Maybe you are living in USA, you want to ship it within USA, so this is where you fill the USA part. So you can calculate the shipping cost and add it here, or you can take it as free shipping. So you can also include if it's a local pickup and you can handle it, and I add the cost right here, right? So that's how to add it. Then when it comes to international shipping, you can also add whether it's same cost to all buyers or calculated cost to a specific location, which I highly encourage guys to put. Cost varies via location, so if you are living in a far away places, the shipping cost will be more costly. So just make it like that. That's my own recommendation for you guys. So ship to, you put worldwide, you can put the services you want to use, whether it's UPS or eBay international service, standard delivery, or you want to use any of these services, you can use them. You can leave it at eBay international standard delivery, and you can calculate the shipping fee. You can put the dimension, size, the weight by inch. You can put the weight here and the dimension as well. So you can exclude some countries that you don't want to ship to. If you don't want any country to be able to see your item or buy your item, you can exclude some countries here. And one cool thing about eBay is that it works internationally, worldwide. It doesn't matter where you are, you can use this and start making money for yourself and start selling some items that you want to sell online internationally, whether it's mass item or just a single item, you can start selling them online. So that's the way to go about it. And the bonus tip I promised you guys is, once you want to ship out the item, you have to put a physical note telling the buyer, thank you for purchasing my item, I would highly encourage you to leave a positive review on the item after buying. Just log into eBay and leave a positive review, and leave it as a physical note inside the box that you want to ship across. So that's the way I encourage you guys to go about it. Then once you are done, click on list item. So that's why you click on list item, then they release the item online, so they will notify you about the item progress and all that. So that's it for this video, guys. That being said, guys, I'll see you guys on my next video.